to go through a make-believe warfare, to prepare us for combat. And as I think about combat, and as I think about warfare on this earth, in which the military is involved in, I'm reminded as I've looked at the need of sex that as believers, we are in a spiritual warfare. We have Satan as our number one enemy. He wants to trip us up. And he wants to take and try to keep us from following Jesus Christ. In the past, there have been evangelists, and past pastors who have taught that when you accept Jesus Christ in your heart, all your troubles vanish. Your life is an open door for no one out of your bottles. But that's not true. Sure, Jesus Christ gives us purpose. He gives us victory as we go through trials. But when we accept Jesus Christ into our lives, Satan doesn't like it. And Satan is going to try to thwart every effort that we make in regards to serving the Lord and following Jesus Christ. And so we have to be reminded of that. We have to realize that, hey, we are in a warfare. And we learn in Ephesians 1 to 3, chapters 1 to 3, we learn more that the believer has been blessed with spiritual blessings and every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. We learn there in the first three chapters that we've been guaranteed an inheritance up in heaven. Nobody can take it from us. Thank you.
We are involved in a spiritual warfare, folks.